Here's another handy concurrency primitive. It's a parallel for loop, or parfor for short. Now, if you ever run off on your own to read classic papers in the parallel algorithms literature, you'll sometimes see such loops described as for any loops or for all loops. So what does a parfor mean? When you use a parfor, you're saying that all iterations are independent of one another. In other words, you can execute the iterations in any order. To put it in DAG terms, a parfor creates n independent subpaths. You can think of this as executing n independent spawns simultaneously if such a thing were possible. Hey, what does he mean, if such a thing were possible? That smells suspiciously like a quiz. Now, by convention, the end of a parfor loop will include an implicit sync point. The implicit sync point will force all of these independent paths to join. Now, suppose every iteration has a constant cost. That is, imagine calling foo of I is bounded by a constant. If there are n iterations, then the work of a parfor is just O of n. So what about the span? Now, in theory, if all these foos have constant cost, then you would think that the span is basically a constant. But in practice, what you should expect to see is that the span will actually grow with n, especially when n is really big. If you have, say, an electrical engineering or circuit background, imagine trying to build a circuit that has 100 million paths coming out of a gate. So to understand this point, I want you to think about two different implementations of a parfor using only spawn and sync, and see what happens.